Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate, Enhanced Edition. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. I have decreased the music volume a little bit. I noticed in the combat sections it was a little overpowering.
Such menial tasks.
Entering the inner courtyard, I'm guessing. Here's another tutor.
Hello, child. Shall we continue your lessons?
If you wish, I can advise you on how to best survive the challenges this world may throw at you. I'm not going to read all this, but... Thaco. Two-hit armor class 0. It's the number your attack roll must meet or exceed to successfully hit a creature with an armor class of 0. The lower your Thaco, the more likely you are to hit a target. Our Thaco is horrible. I think we're at 25. With 3rd edition, they got rid of Thaco. Armor class. A low or even negative armor class makes you more difficult to hit. Especially negative. Saving throws. They provide a target number you must meet or beat to avoid the worst outcomes of spells or other effects. A lower score is best. Okay. That's a good refresher. I wasn't aware of that. These guys. Voice of the East and all this stuff. Nothing to say? You guys are called voices, but you have no voice.
The world shall wander the earth.
The Lord of Murder shall perish.
And such a pestilence will follow in his way.
Shall spawn a score of mortal progeny.
Shall be chaos will be sown from their passage.
Alrighty then.
Our divine lords will walk alongside us as equals.
This place is... Oh, this is the wall here. Okay, never mind.
Hey-ya! It's me, Imowen!
Oh, you're cut off there. Hi, Amarin. Imowen. I'm surprised the stuffy old Gorion let you away from your studies and chores. That old fiddle-faddle. I snuck off, too. Old Puffguts Winthrop was looking for me. But I've got all day to do his chores. You have time for a story today? No, I can tell you don't. What have you been up to? Imowen, yay! Either way, I would tell her a story. Because I have a way of procrastinating against Gorion's wishes. I'm sorry, child, but I am not to tell anyone what I am doing. I must go. You should not tarry about either. Winthrop will want the beds turned down after you are done in the stables. If you say so. You sure have picked up a lot from old Gorion. He never tells it straight, neither. Good luck on your trip. Good luck with whatever you were doing. Wait, what do you know of my journey? Gorion has said little to me and less to anyone else. Oh, I know. Old stuck in the mud that he is. All worried about nothing, I'm sure. Better go now, because you got a long ways to travel. Not that I would know, especially since I didn't peek at old Mr. G's private letters. No, ma'am. Better go now. Bye-bye.
Yep.
Don't keep Mr. G waiting now. Come on, you get going. Mr. G. I am gonna look around a little bit. Anything else to be seen around here? Not sure. Yeah, I don't see
greetings, young one.
Hi. Oh, Testorel, I need to talk to you. Firebeat has sent you to me, hasn't he? Very well, return this scroll to him, but then you must hurry and speak with Gorion. He is waiting for you on the steps of the Central Library. I assure you, child, it's a matter of greatest urgency. I retrieved the scroll from Testorel. I should probably head back to the inn and return it to Firebeat. Oh, where'd you go? How do you do that?
I am very proud of you, as I am sure Gorion is.
Oh, thank you. Go to Gorion and listen well, for without knowledge, life is a mere shadow of death. That's sad. I talked to him already.
Hello, child.
Yes.
Shall we continue your lessons?
No, my lessons are complete. Is this the inn? Yeah. Firebead. Got your scroll. Took a look at it. I want to keep it, actually. With this spell memorized, go to the description of an unidentified item and press the Identify button. Chance of identifying the item is 100%. The spell identifies the item's name, what it does, and if it is cursed. Now, I could write magic, but that mean the scroll would disappear, and we'd be unable to complete Firebeat's quest. Sad to say, I guess you can't have your cake and eat it too.
Fine.
It's hard to find decent folk nowadays.
I am glad to see that age is not hard in your heart towards an old man such as myself. I'll take all of your identify scrolls. I have a great use for those types of scrolls. Here, allow me to cast a little spell on you. It will protect you from any evil you might meet tonight. Thank you. Old Firebead was grateful for my help. You cast a spell on me and said it would protect me from any evil I might meet tonight. I don't know what's out there beyond these walls, but I guess I'll find out soon enough.
It's hard to find decent folk nowadays.
I believe Gorion is waiting for you at the Central Library. You had best hurry there. I don't suppose this guy has any cloak or anything like that. I wonder if I can see what kind of active effects I have on my person. I have some pretty decent saving throws, I think. Protection from evil. Good to know. Next level is quite a ways away. Now, cloak, I could use something. Boots, belt, maybe? How much money do we have? Does it even say? Maybe we have to get into 93.
My hotel's as clean as an elven arse.
Interesting, he wouldn't buy the potion of healing. I don't think I can use this. Not usable by mage, monk, etc. Bracers are thick bands of metal or leather that are strapped, belted, or tied to a character's forearm. Generally, the magic that is instilled in bracers is good only during combat, since most bracers help protect the wearer from injury or improve their chances to strike an opponent. Exceptions do exist, though such specialized items are rare at best. Now, it doesn't look like it gives you any AC bonus. Oh, would it not show that? Armor class 8. So here it shows. Girdles are generally similar to belts. Unlike belts, girdles are not used to hold up pants and dungarees, but to carry pouches, scabbards, and the like. It doesn't look like he's selling anything that we can wear to increase our armor class. I can't use leather armor. Guess we're done in here.
Such menial tasks.
The Central Library. The Great Alonzo. Wise Alondo.
What you want?
Alright. Guess I have nothing left to do. Anything else? The Candlekeep Infirmary. I suppose that's inside. Inside here. Inside Candlekeep. Well, that's Gorion. Can I just... Can I get past you? Locked. Oh, I guess we can't force this door. Hi, Gorion.
Oh, my child, I am glad I have found you.
This is very unnerving, I know, but you must trust me. It is very important that you pack your possessions so that we may leave Candlekeep immediately. Hurry, for there is no time to tarry. The keep is well protected, but not invulnerable. What should I bring with me on this journey? If you would just give me some clue as to what I will need. My dear child, you should know yourself well enough to purchase the gear you need. I have given you what I can spare, so hurry off to the inn and speak with Winthrop. Use your skills as a reference and buy what basics you must, though spend wisely. His prices are fair, but you may not have enough gold to purchase all that you would want. Please, Father, tell me where we will be going. Alas, I cannot. But I have not truly decided yet. All that is certain is that we will be far safer on the move. Perhaps the woods might offer some secluded security, or perhaps the city of Baldur's Gate would offer cover amidst its teeming throngs of people. I do not know where we shall end up, but I have a few friends here and there. I will think on this. What could possibly harm us here? This place is a fortress, and guarded beyond measure. Kind of weird for me to be saying that. I mean, I've been attacked by two different assassins. Candlekeep is indeed a formidable obstacle for ne'er-do-wells, but it is not insurmountable. No matter how thick the mesh, at least one mosquito always finds its way through. No, my child, you must leave as soon as possible for our safety and that of our friends here. Just wait a little longer. There are a few more things I must do. How do I get to the Candlekeep Infirmary? Clinic? This is where we practice, though. Let's just try over here. That's the clinic there. Oh, okay. I didn't know about this area. Sleeping woman. Sleeping halfling. There's Sir Trun over there.
Such menial tasks.
Well, he's pacing rapidly.
These walls contain the world's knowledge.
And a lot of sick people. So are you sick? You look rather healthy to me, but you never can tell. Do you need any potions or such things? Yes, that'd be nice of you. All right, then. Take this potion. Sweet. I got a potion of healing. So now I have two. I suppose I could put this under quick items. You want to give me any more?
Wisdom is only possessed by the learned.
I am very busy with my patients. I'll have to ask that you give me some room. I don't know what's up with the teleporting people. Who is the glum knight standing in the corner over there? That is my problem patient, Sir Trun. Actually, his wounds are more or less healed, but he doesn't know how he should go and confront his fiancée, who is staying at the inn. So he stays, all lost in thought. Maybe you can talk to him. I think this is an added-on quest. It's Linda back in the Candlekeep Inn.
These walls contain the world's knowledge.
Oh, reader? Who's a reader? Read me a story, reader.
No, excuse me, but I'm late for my classes.
Hey there, no time to chat. I have a mountain of dishes to tackle. I thought you said glasses. Or classes. F3. Get out of here. I'm trying to force my way into here. I can't do it with you standing over me. You'll be displeased with me. Now they're all going in there. Hail, Sir Trun.
Yes?
What do you want? Please let me rest. Or rest. Elmer Fudd, as you can see, I am injured. Who are you? I am Sir Trun, and am currently in this infirmary to recover from the injuries I sustained in my last fight. I talked to your fiancée. The poor woman doesn't feel well at all. I know, and it tortures me that I am incapable of helping her. It is like I am paralyzed. My injury is no reason for my behavior toward her. I fell in love with a beautiful young maiden and proposed to her, and now... You can't handle the thought she might be stronger than you? No, no, not that. I... Since she already talked to you, it won't hurt if I do so, too. Actually, I feel a great urge to talk about this with someone who cares to listen. We got into an unexpected fight. Everything was going well. Then all of a sudden, one of the creatures sunk its teeth into my arm. I wasn't able to free myself, and it was dragging me toward the portal. There was a pain at my shoulder, and next thing I knew, I was lying in front of the portal, watching it close behind the last of the monsters. Linda was standing behind me, pale as a ghost, my sword in her hands. She saved my life the only way it was possible in that moment, by chopping off my arm. I am not talking about the loss of my arm. That was lost the moment the monster bit into it. Got some options here. I don't like either of these two. What bothers you is her sudden foresight and prowess. Not only did she understand the only way to save you, she also did it in what must have been a time frame of mere seconds, and all that despite the fact that she is only the daughter of a noble house. Yes, that's it. That is what keeps troubling me. She's completely inexperienced if it comes to fighting, yet she acts like a long-established knight. I couldn't have done it better, had I been in her position. The sensible detachment she showed by cutting off another's arm, if it was the only way to save him, how much experience must one gain? How many friends must one lose in battle before developing this insight? She just did it, when it was necessary. My poor Linda. Surely she is terribly frightened, but how should I confront her, after being so distant toward her? All she did was save me. I like that. I kind of like the idea, but it establishes her as being less than her, or that he would think of her as being less than him, to be his squire. Interesting idea, though. A present would also be a good idea, but first thing you should go do is go talk to her. You should seek communication with Linda. It would help you both if you could talk about it. We tried talking, but it didn't work. No, I have to bring something with me when I go to her. If only I could think of something appropriate. What an awkward situation. Maybe you might find her a nice present? I can't think of anything. Anything I'd love to give her under normal conditions doesn't seem to fit here. I have to think about it some more. Kidding me?
Yes?
I have returned. No, I haven't moved. I think, I guess the option is to take her as a squire? So have you come up with a good idea since we last met?
Yes?
I guess this is the only option. There is only one possibility. Linda has to learn how to fight, so you will have to teach her. Take her as your squire. I beg your pardon? That is absurd. She's a young maiden, innocent and frail. And she shows the fighting prowess of an experienced knight. There is more to your fiancé than you thought, Sir Trun. Wait. I see what you mean. It is hidden inside her, isn't it? The gift shows differently in different people. Some know from early childhood where their path will lead. For others, the revelation comes all of a sudden as a great surprise. Yes, it seems the only way to go forward and leave this horrible memory behind us. She made the first step onto this path. To expect her to return to her former life would be cruel and unrealistic. I will go to her now. I'll be approaching her with an unusual present for a woman of her origin. My sword. My body recovered a long time ago. It was my mind that felt injured and wouldn't come to rest. You dragged me out of my thoughts in despair, and I thank you deeply. We are in your debt. Now I will go to her. I am eager to see how she will react. Is she really ready for this? I am also bothered as to what I will tell her parents, who imagine their daughter on an educational journey in Candlekeep. Gives a weary smile. Farewell. In case we don't meet again, may Tyr protect you. My reputation increased by one. I got 150 experience. I help Sir Trun overcome his problem. He will train Linda in swordplay. Hopefully they can overcome the horrible adventure they had. Alright, can I see what's in here now? Oh, damn it. Yes. I don't think we're going to be able to get in there. And I'm nothing like an ogre to be able to break open locks. Alright, whatever then.
Pleased to make your acquaintance.
Oh, there she is. Ah, here you are. Linda, I deeply wanted to thank you. Trun came to me and he offered me the opportunity to become his squire. At first I thought he'd lost his mind completely, but when he kneeled down and handed over his sword, he told me it was you who made him understand, and I see what he means. It is the only way to overcome this nightmare. It will help us both to accept what happened. Whatever works. Maybe he will fall in love with his fighting squire just as he fell in love with the maiden once. Maybe. For now, he has a task as a knight. As do I, a squire. May Lathander bless you with all his power. Farewell.
Such menial tasks.
And just that, they're gone. Alright, good. All quests complete.
This way.
Who's that? A test turtle again?
Name it.
What'd she say? Alright. Gorion, I think we're finally ready.
You must learn to be patient, child.
I'm ready to go right now.
Listen carefully. If we ever become separated, it is imperative that you make your way to the Friendly Arm Inn. There you will meet Khalid and Jahira. They have long been my friends, and you can trust them. Let's hurry, child. The night can only get worse, so we must find shelter soon. Don't worry. Explain everything as soon as there is time.
Wish I could zoom in on that.
There is something wrong. We are in an ambush. Prepare yourself.
You're perceptive for an old man. You know why I'm here. Hand over your ward and no one will be hurt. If you resist, it shall be a waste of your life.
You're a fool if you believe I would trust your benevolence. Step aside and you and your lackeys will be unhurt.
I am sorry that you feel that way, old man.
I am flooded.
Yeah, I can't zoom in or even pause.
The dawn is especially cruel this morning. You awake with the realization that you have not been living some horrible dream. Ambushed, you saw Gorion cut down before your eyes, and even his powerful magic could not stop the onslaught. It was his wish that you flee, but that does not remove the feeling of helplessness that now overwhelms you. Hand over your ward. The armored fiend had said. He was after you and you alone, but why? If only Gorion had given some clue. but now you are alone and lost. Candlekeep is near, but you will find no quarter there. The readers pay for their serenity with rather draconian entry rules, and without Gorion's influence, their doors will remain closed. You will not last long on your own with your meager equipment. Perhaps you can get some help from the friends Gorion mentioned, the ones at the Friendly Arm.
How devastating. The only father we've known for all our lives has now been struck down, gone forever. And we can't get back inside Candlekeep. Unable to bring any books with us. I know that's very minor in comparison to what has just occurred.
Hey, it's me, Emmowen.
Sorry I followed you, but I never get out of Candlekeep, and those monks are such a bore. Never any decent coin in their pockets, neither. I saw Gorion, and I'm so sorry. Kinda figured something bad might happen to you out here. How could you have known? Gorion did not even tell me. I accidentally read a letter on his desk the other day. Can't remember exactly what it said, but he might still have... It might be on his body. Anyway, I'm not gonna let you wander out here all alone. Never let a friend down. No, ma'am. Stick with you till I say otherwise. Until you say otherwise, I will. Okay, so now I have Imowin in our party. And she has stuff. Look at that. 3 potions of healing. She has an oil of speed. She has a wand of magic missiles. I'll take that. A quiver with 40 arrows. And a short bow. Sometimes I just like to read the descriptions of equipment. I know for the enchanted equipment, specially constructed things is really interesting, but... Short bows were the first bows to be developed, although they were not called such. This is more of a default term that refers to anything which is not a longbow. Short bow staves are about 5 feet long on the average. As the years passed, attempts were made to increase bow ranges. Bows were either given longer staves or flexibility was increased with no change to the length. The former resulted in what is now called the longbow. Can I have one of those? Thank you. A wand of magic missiles. Pretty sweet. With 10 charges. Did she say anything else?
Fine.
Imowin seems a little quiet for her. Funnily enough, you do not know all that much about your oldest friend. Perhaps this is a good time to find out what Imowin is all about. You ask Imowin lots of personal questions. You talk about Imowin's problems and hopes in a friendly and kind manner, in hopes of making Imowin confide in you. This must be part of the chatty Imowin mod. Come on, you know everything about me. Well, not everything. Like how I made the whole Citadel believe that Nessa ate Fuller's underpants, but the rest you pretty much know. You are used to hearing things from the bottom of people's hearts, so you try to charm Imowin into telling you more about herself. I'm just thinking about Gorion and what would have become of us if he hadn't died, or we can never go back to Candlekeep after what's happened. I feel so bad, like I'm angry at him for dying. Silly, huh? She She lowers her head as tears begin to well up in her eyes. I'm fine, really. Thank you for asking, though. So, Imowen, can you tell me more about yourself? I'm a little tired for these types of discussions right now. How's this adventure going? Well, I guess overall it's better than washing dishes in Winthrop's Inn, but almost anything is better than that. What seems to be wrong, Imowen? Just wondering what's going on back in Candlekeep is all. She doesn't have much more to say. So I wonder where we are compared to Gorion. But that looks like an episode or an adventure for another time. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and always seek adventure.